This is Hockey Talkies, monthly summary show for the month of November 2022. We hope you enjoy Rogie's crazy thoughts about the going-ons in hockey, and we also hope you consider subscribing to the chat channel. Okay people, let's roll it. This is Hockey Talkie, for the week of October 31st to November 4th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
How bad is the Western Conference in the National Hockey League? The kid says really, really bad. Ottawa Senators are playing 500 hockey, but are 15 plays, out of 16 teams, in Eastern Conference. Only one team is worse, the Columbus, Blue Jackets. This is crazy. Ottawa would be close to being in playoffs, in Western Conference. Does it matter that there are many weaker teams in Western Conference? No. Probably not. They have the current Stanley Cup champions, and probably will again. What do you think? Will Stanley Cup champions come from the weaker Western Conference in 2023? Me, think
this
so.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 1st, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. You know, my dad said it a few days ago, and the kid will say it now. The Toronto Maple Leafs need to dig deep, really deep. Hey guys, get to work with some grit and determination. Oh my goodness, TML players. Play okay, and entertain like you can. You know, please accept my apologies if a number of you are under the weather. The kid hopes you get well soon. What do you think? Are the Toronto Maple Leafs ill? Let us know with your ideas and comments, down below.
This is Hockey Talkie, for November 2nd, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. Watch out. Don't get trampled by the Buffalo Sabres. They are crushing their opposition. Leading their charge is a old Las Vegas player, Alex Tuck. What a great trade by Buffalo management to get Tuck. Tuck is a winner, is a crazy great player, and most important, want to be and play in Buffalo. Will the Buffalo Sabres charge into the playoff this year? What do you think? Let us know with your...
This is Hockey Talkie, for November 3rd, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Winnipeg Jets are flying high this year. Rogie, think Connor Hellebuyck, Zergo Ali, is one big reason, roaring by team. Hellebuyck is play crazy fantastic. However, Hellebuyck could get super tired, especially when Jets play 8 games in 13 days this month. Can Hellebuyck and the Jets keep winning? Me, think so. What do you think? Let us know with your ideas and...
For November 4th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. Goalie Logan Thompson, of the Las Vegas Golden Knights, is helping them get off to a quality start this season. Who would have thought that? Not me. It is well known that goalies can be like wine. They take time to become what they really can be. At 21, Thompson went back to Brock University, in Canada. Thompson played his way up, through two minor leagues. And now finds himself, supporting Las Vegas in winning hockey games. Good on him, and Rogie the kid, OP keeps it up. Don't you? Let us know with you.
This is Hockey Talking, for the week of November 7th to November 11th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Seattle Kraken are for real. Well, at least for now, this hockey season. Currently they are second in the Pacific Division. Third in their conference. And 6th overall. That is super crazy good for them, don't you think? We are definitely not watching last year's Kraken hockey at all. Management know what they are doing, obviously. First, putting Gourde on third line. Starting Martin, in goal. And of course, limiting Shane Wright's ice time. What do you think about the Kraken management? Let
this
us know with you.
For November 8, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The St. Louis Blues are playing the funk. That is, they are playing Crazy Terry BL. Which will make them all blue, very blue. It is not a good situation in St. Louis. Is it the coaching? The kids think not. Is it their goaltending? The kids think it not perfect, but not bad either. What the kids think is that they need a little. No, they need a great deal more from Jordan Kyrou. Their new $8 million player. It is early in the season, and we all know it is a long season. So here's hoping Jordan can play like he can. To help the Blues get more wins. What do you think are causing the Blues, Woos? Let us know your thoughts.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 9, 2022. Here's Rogan, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. Is it time for the Vancouver Canucks to shake it up? The kids think so. Bring in some young players into the lineup to let them grow and learn. How about Jack Radbone and Kyle Burrows? The kids think give them a chance. What about moving some assets for more draft picks? Speaking of draft picks, wouldn't Connor Bedard, from the Regina Pat, look crazy great playing in his home city next year? Rogi, think it would be pretty crazy sweet for the Canucks. What do you think? Let us know your thoughts.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 10, 2022. Here's Rogi, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. Have we, as hockey fans, become numb to how super, crazy fantastic, both Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl are, as hockey players? The kids think so. Currently they are 1-2 in the scoring grass. And the Edmonton Oilers and their fans are lucky to have and see them play every day. Those two phenoms are crazy dominant, and you know together, they have about 1/2 of the total goals their team has scored this season. Rogi, the kid, Marchand résistance and claps for TZ2 special players. Kudos to you Connor and Leon, keep it up. What do you think? Have the fans become numb to how good TZ2 players are for
this
the Oilers?
This is Hockey Talkie for November 11, 2022. Here's Rogi, the kid, Marchand.
Hello everybody. Will the Anaheim Ducks float above the 500 mark this season? The kid thinks not. Don't be mistaken. There is some incredible talent in Anaheim. For example, Trevor Zegrash. Can you believe how crazy fantastic he looks, doing the Michigan goals? However, let's remember, looking good doesn't win hockey games. So, does Anaheim worry about look, or winning? What
this
do
is
you
Hockey
see?
Talking, for the week of November 14th to November 18th, 2022. Here's Rogi, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. Well, this probably won't surprise anyone. That, one of my favorite teams in hockey, is from a French-speaking province, in Canada. And I have to say, who really can't like them right now. The Montreal Canadiens are performing way better than the experts expected. This makes Rogi very, very happy. What a foundation Montreal is building, around the young, and mature captain, Nick Suzuki. Also, what a trade they made to get Kirby Dar. He is playing crazy good, and he is only 21 years old. Will the Canadiens make the playoff this year? The kid, sure hopes, so. What
this
do you
is
think?
Hockey Talkie, for November 15, 2022. Here's Rogi, the kid, Marchand.
Hello everybody. Well, the New Jersey Devils are a devilishly hot team right now. They are playing super crazy great. The Devils have won 12 of their first 15 games this season. Don't change anything. Correct? No? Wrong everyone. The kids think they must, yes they must, get another goaltender for this season. This is the one spot that will stop the Devils from winning in the playoff. What do you think? Do the Devils need another goaltender? Let us know your thoughts down
this
below.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 16, 2022. Here's Rogi, the kid, Marchand.
Hello everybody. The Washington Capitals are in a silly and unfamiliar spot in the standings. They should not be happy about it. Their casual approach to their hockey games have them winning only about half of their games. Again, they should not be happy about this. Is it their goaltending? Well, no. The Capitals rank third in the league, in goal expected to be saved, by their goaltenders. In other words, their goaltending is performing well, right now. Maybe the return of their coach from COVID protocol will help heal the casual play of the rest of the team. What do you think? Let us know your thoughts.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 17, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Tampa Bay Lightning keep rolling and thundering along season after season. They are impressive, as they always seem to make the Stanley Cup playoff. Part of their success is due to having a very solid and steady player named Steven Stamkos in their lineup for the past 15 years. This week, Stamkos reached a crazy, fantastic milestone by scoring his 500th assist. Not only has Stamkos helped Lightning players to score 500 goals, he has scored 489 goals himself. Amazing! Congratulations Steven, and the kid, hopes you can keep it rolling, for the Tampa Bay Lightning. See you tomorrow, at Hockey Talkie.
This is Hockey Talkie, for November 18, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. We all knew the Chicago Blackhawks were not going to be good this season. But really, they are doing incredibly crazy good job at not being very good. For example, the Blackhawks team is last in the league in shot attempt and second last in both shooting percentage and creating quality scoring chances. There are more stats. But need the kid say more? No! Should the Blackhawks start the rebuild soon, or better yet, should they have started it yesterday? Let us know what you think with your comments down below.
This is Hockey Talking for the week of November 21st to November 25th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Los Angeles Kings are playing consistently. Inconsistent, so far this season. This drives their fans and their coach to tears. They show brilliance when defeating the very fast and talented Edmonton Oilers. Then they show their ugliness when losing to the not-so-strong Vancouver Canucks. Good thing for the Kings and their coach Todd McClellan that we are in the first half of the season. Will the Kings develop consistency in their hockey play and make the playoff?
This is what Hockey Talkie for November 22nd, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. You know, the Pittsburgh Penguins have been a very solid team for years, and are just starting to hit their stride for this season. It took them a little while to get going, but you know, they are no spring chickens anymore. Led for years by the dynamic duo Sidney Crosby, who just so happened to be named the first star of this week for his great play. And Evgeny Malkin, who just played his 1000th game in the league. The Penguins should make the playoff this year, the kid thinks. Do you think the dynamic duo will get the Penguins into the playoff this year? Let us know what you think.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 23rd, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Minnesota Wild are playing 500 hockey this season. This currently isn't good enough to make the playoff. Their top two scorers, Kirill Kaprizov and Matt Zuccarello, produce points. Actually, they have about 25% of Minnesota total scoring points, that's crazy good. However, for this production, they are a combined minus 12. And both are close to being the very worst on the team in this stat category. Are their points coming on the power play? Probably. The kit strongly suggests that two players improve their 5-on-5 play for Minnesota to have any kind of chance of making the playoff. What do you think about the Wild and the playoff? Is it a wild dream for them this season? Let us know what you think down below.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 24, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Columbus Blue Jackets have been so disappointing this year. The two big signings of Patrick Laine, Mr. Hockey, Johnny Gaudreau, have not been as good as expected. Thank goodness the future looks bright for Columbus, as they have a long list of young, talented hockey players. Should the Blue Jackets move on from Johnny and Patrick? I'm sure there will be takers as the season progresses. Should Columbus dangle Johnny and Patrick in front of the other teams? It could be tempting for those teams to bite. To dangle, or not to dangle, good question. Let us know what you think.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 25th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody. The Carolina Hurricanes are not even a minor tropical storm right now. They have lost 7 games in November, so far. Their power play is ineffective, and their advanced replay is even worse. The team is having trouble scoring goal, and most recently, got shut out by the Arizona Coyotes. The Coyotes. Oh my goodness. Something must change, don't you think? Is it the coach? Or are some players' movement necessary? Or, will time just steal the cans, bad play? What do you think? Please let us know your ideas, and thoughts on
this is Hockey Talking, for the week of November 28th to December 2nd, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Everybody, the San Jose Sharks are the last team of the 32 teams that the kid looked at so far this season. The Sharks are a toothless hockey team this season, just like they were the previous 3 years. The kid is very impressed with the resurgence of defenseman Carl Erickson. However, his crazy great play will not be enough to propel the Sharks into the playoffs. Management should consider trading him and other assets like Timo Meier to start the absolutely necessary rebuild of the Sharks team. What do you think, Shark fan?
This is Hockey Talkie for November 29, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Hello everybody, the Ottawa Senators have not performed as well as we thought this season. Rogie has been wrong in the prediction of them making the playoff. We were wrong, and for the crazy warning to other teams of their skill and talent. Again, we were wrong. Can the Senators bounce back from their crazy pathetic start? The kid thinks so, and suggests the Senators keep their crazy good talent. Don't trade, and just play hard. Hopefully, this steady plan will help them make the playoff this season. What do you think? Okay, fine.
This is Hockey Talkie for November 30th, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
The Las Vegas Golden Knights are flying high, and the kid means they are super high. Their rookie goaltender, Logan Thompson, is playing crazy fantastic. Their new coach is a brilliant gem, and as the kid correctly predicted early in this hockey talkie show. Jack Eichel is getting used to, or acclimatizing, to the Las Vegas scene and vibe. Which means really good things and wins for the Knights. Jack is leading the Knights in scoring with 11 goals, 15 assists, and a crazy super awesome plus, minus rating of plus 15. Yes, Jack is comfortable in Las Vegas. Good on him and the team. All the kid can say right now is, keep on rolling, Golden Knights.
This is Hockey Talkie for December 1st, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
Rogie, the kid is very proud of himself. The Toronto Maple Leafs actually heard me, yes heard me, with my hockey talkie rant, directed at them last month. Just listen to me back when, ranting on them. The Toronto Maple Leafs need to dig deep, really deep. Hey guys, get to work with some grit and determination. Oh my goodness, TML players. Play hockey and entertain like you can. Thank you Maple Leafs, you truly, though not sure the entire hockey world yet, that this year might be different from your previous year's outcomes. Keep up the hard and gritty work you are doing over the past months. Your crazy fantastic skill and talent, along with disrespectful hard work, is really paying off. Congratulations to you, and I guess, congratulations to me too.
This is Hockey Talkie for December 2nd, 2022. Here's Rogie, the kid, Marshawn.
The Dallas Stars continue to do what we said they absolutely would do at the start of the season. And that is sparkle, win, and make the playoff. Why? Well, there are two good reasons. One is Jamie Benn, who has played like a beast all season on the power play. Benn has more points this year on the power play than he did all of last year. The second reason is Jason Robertson, who has 15 goals, yes 15 goals, at Evans Treplay. That is crazy amazing Jason. Congratulations, keep up the dazzling sparkles, Stars. You are having a crazy great season in Dallas. Keep it up, bye everyone, and see you on Monday.